Hi guys, this is Anash Sharma and in this session we will discuss the DAX functions all selected and all except. First of all, we check the data for using the DAX function. So we have the data for the country, product, quantity sold. Now suppose we want to calculate the reports for the Canada country total sales. It means we need to apply the filter only for the Canada country or combination of the some like country and the product, Canada and Japan. Or we want to like calculate the unit price, gross sales for a particular region or particular product or particular country. It means we need filters. When you create the measure, so measure jo hai by default works in the filter context, but the column doesn't. The column does not work in the filter context. So when we create the measure, we can change the filter behavior using this function all selected and all except. First of all, we check the all function. All function, it return all the row in a table. What it mean? It means it return the tables, but before that, it removes all the filters, which is already applied on by default, removes or ignore the filters. This is very similar to the remove filters. This is the DAX function. If you apply the remove filters, so this will remove all the filters from the function. The syntax is all then table name or column name. You can mention here table name or column name here, and the square bracket shows. It means it indicates this parameter is the optional. If you observe the square parameter, it means that parameter is the optional. The name of existing table or column, and that table must be exist in your data model. Then column name and column. Again, it says square bracket, means column name is also optional. Then second is the repeatable. Repeatable means with the all function, you can mention the multiple column name here. And that column must be from the same base table. This table, and the return type of this all function is the table. It means if you use this function all function, this will return the data in a table format. Now we check the all function with the practical. So you can observe the data already uploaded, report section, table, then country. Now we create the measure, calculate, then some net sales. So this measure created, drag and drop this measure in table. Now you can observe we applied the formula sum. Sum means the total of the whole columns, all value of that column, but here we have the total country wise because this measure is working in a context filter. If we add the one more column, that is the product. Now you can see the figure again change. Now this time this figure is for the Canada country and the product is the CPU. This is the total sale. Again the country Canada and the product is a different pad, and this is the figure. So it means this measure is working in the context filter, and if you add more data, more column in these tables, then the figure will also change because of the context filter. Now we add a slicer, then country, we add another slicer, and in this slicer we take product. So we have the list of the country and we have the list of the another slicer, we have the list of the product. If I select the Canada, so we have the data only for the Canada country with all product. Now if I choose France, then the France, then Germany for the Germany country. If I click the CPU, then CPU in Germany, and now so CPU for all countries. So this is the figure for this. So this is proved that this measure is working in context filter. My requirement is I do not want this measure to work in the filter context. It means I have to remove all the filter context from this measure. How to do that? I will use the all function. So I'll create the new measure, all total sales, then calculate some net sales and comma all. You can observe I'm using the all function without any parameter, because in the all function all the parameters are the optional. So if I apply this one, this all, it means this will remove all filters, all context filter. So now drag and drop this one in table. So you can see, you can observe all filters have been ignored, or all context filter have been removed for this measure. That's why this country and the product name are not being considered for the totaling. So we have the total for this column, say CPU. So total of this column is the 26044, and in this column measure where all filters are being removed or ignored, then we have the same figure each and every cells. Now we applied the all functions for removing all the context filter. Suppose I want to remove the context filter from a particular column, say country or product. Okay, I create new more measure, all filter product, and calculate some, then net sales. This time in all function I'll mention the column name, say product name, and now execute this one. Okay, now drag and drop this one, check the figure. So for this measure, only one column, that is the product, the context filter have been removed from that product. So this total, this is for the country, Canada, 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 same total, because this total is not considering the this product for the calculation, because there is no field, this the filter has been removed from this. So if I change CPU product, again you can see there is no change this one, because there is no filter, there is no filter context on the product. So same data. So this is how you can use the all function in the DAX. Next one is the all except. The all except function can remove all the context filter, but if you want to retain some context filter, then you can mention in this function. Suppose there are 10 context filter and you want to retain 2 out of 10, then you can mention the columns in the this function. The syntax is all except, then table name and column name, that is a compulsory because there is no square bracket, and then column name, again it's a optional and the repeatable. It means you can mention the multiple columns here for which you want to retain the context filter. And the return type of this table, this function is the table. Now we check the all except function in the Power BI. So we have a table with two columns, that country and product. Now we create a measure, all except, then table name, sales summary, and say column name, say country. So in this function we apply the all except function एंड वी आर रिमूविंग ऑल द फिल्टर कॉन्टेस्ट बट वी आर रिटेनिंग द फिल्टर कॉन्टेस्ट ऑन द कंट्री कॉलम. सो इफ आई ड्रैग एंड ड्रॉप दिस वन, so this figure you can see Canada CPU, Canada's pad, Canada. The product are different but still the figure same because this product name is not being considered. We have removed the filter, context filter from the product and only retaining the filter on the country column. Suppose if I change, say rather than country, we product. So it means this time we have the filter only for the product. On the country we removed because now the figure changed. This is the total of the product CPU 10275. Again for the country the France, the product is the CPU. So it means for this calculation, for this measure, the country is not being considered because we have remove the filter context from the country column. So this is how you can use the all except function. So next one is the all selected. The all selected function, it return all the row in a table but ignore all the filters that have been applied in a query and apply a new filter dynamically from the outside. What it mean, we will prove it with the practical. The syntax is all selected, then table name or column name, and it's a square bracket, it means this parameter is optional. Then again column name repeatable, but these are the optional because these are in the square bracket. And the return type is the table, it means the data would be returning in the table format. Now we check how to use the all selected function Power BI. So you can observe we have a table. In table we have a country, product, then net sales, and in net sales the calculation is the country and the product. The second figure, Canada country and the pad. The third figure, Canada and the product is the different. So all this calculation have been done on the basis of the country and the product. Now we create a measure. Net sales. Then all selected. In all selected we define product. So as per the definition of the all selected, if you define some column name then it will remove all the filters which have been applied in the query. But create a filter dynamically at runtime when you pass some value or some parameter from the outside for the product. Okay, we include this all selected. Now we can check the value for the Canada country. The value is the same because this calculation is only for the Canada country. Three values, all three values, and the product for the calculation purpose has been ignored. This means this filter has been ignored. Now same thing with the other country, the France, Germany. Now we take a slicer, and in a slicer we take the product region because we have to pass the some parameter for the product from the outside because the product column has been defined in the all selected function. So you can see now in a slicer we have the list of the product, and if I click on the CPU, it means this calculation, all these three calculation should change. Region, this calculation should be based on the country and the product. Because when I click the CPU, it means I am passing a parameter from outside. And that parameter from outside will apply a filter dynamically on this measure. So I click CPU, now the figure are the same. Canada, France, Germany, because now this calculation are also on the basis of the country and the product. If I click say mouse multiple, the figures are change. So this is how you can use the all selected function. So guys, this was all about the dash function, all selected and all except. Thanks for watching the video.